Let us talk about bisection method. Assume that we would like to find a minimum of a function of one variable. To find minimum of a function of smooth function, it's the same as find the zero of its derivative. And bisection is a general method for finding zero or root of function of one variable. Assume also that we know interval from a0 to b0 where the root is located. The method is very simple. We take a middle point of the interval a0 b0 tau and look on the sign of our function at this point. If sign is opposite to the sign at a0, we know that root is located on the left subinterval. Otherwise, on the right. So in our example, we choose the left subinterval and again take middle point and evaluate function in this middle point and check its sign. Now we see that sign is opposite to the sign on the right side of the new interval, so we choose right subinterval and so on. The method is very simple and it reduces uncertainty interval rather fast. It divides by 2 at every iteration, so after k iteration the length of our uncertainty interval is 2 to the power minus k multiplied by length of original interval. For example, after 10 iterations we will reduce error about 1000 times, and after 20 iterations about 1000000 times. So the method is rather fast, despite that the methods which we will learn later, quadratic or cubic interpolation, will allow even faster decrease of the function of the uncertainty if our function is well approximated by quadratic or cubic polynomial. Here is a very simple MATLAB type code expressing our algorithm. We consider a simple case when sine of the derivative is negative on the left side and positive on the right side. And it's true if our function is so-called unimodal, so it decreases on the left side from of the minimum and increases on the right side. So we perform n iteration, n maybe 10, 20, 30, not very large number. We evaluate middle point of the interval and just check sine of derivative in this middle point. If it's positive, then we move right side of the interval to this point. Otherwise, we move left side of the interval. So, as you see, the implementation is extremely short.